Okay, here we are testing the new preamp design. Right now I'm running it on 5 volts. This meter is showing the output collector's difference to ground. It's sitting at minus 1.06 volts. And the preamp here is on all these test leads. Signal's on the scope. We have a convenient pulse generator here. It's called cold cathode fluorescent. Now, because of this waveform, the average voltage appears to increase on the voltmeter, but if you look on the scope real carefully, we're actually getting closer to ground on the positive part of this waveform as we drive it harder, and it's giving us almost, well, 4 and change volts peak to peak on a 5 volt supply. Now one thing that's interesting about this is I can now run the supply voltage down to, let's call it 2 volts. Now we're 0.98 volts off ground, and look at the scope. It's still working pretty much perfectly. In fact, that's about where it's symmetric. Or we can run it all the way up to whatever we want here. Call it 10, 12 volts, 12.6 volts, 1.12 volts on the collector. It's harder to make it clip. Okay, this is drawing about a milliamp and a half, which is a little bit more than I wanted, but it's a brake, and you know, it should drive coax pretty good. Here, even on 4, 5, 6 volts. We don't really change the gain with the voltage either. It's just a question of, after I'll run the voltage down, we'll just start clipping at some point, but the gain doesn't really change. The gain is pretty rock solid. Okay. So, there it is. It is a thing of beauty. And I'll put it through some more beating to see if it's how fast I can make it, but it should be quite fast. Plenty fast enough for what I have in mind. And it appears to be completely rock stable. We're changing 30, 40 millivolts of collector offset off of ground for the full supply range of 2.2 volts to, geez, I don't know, I only tried it about 15. What's the point? So there we have it.